Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to take a look at the design procedure of the fillet beds and what are the different terminologies which will be used during the design process. So let's start. So the fillet weld is done for the members which overlap each other. The fillet weld is a type of welded connection which is done for the members which are overlapping each other. And in this, the welding material is provided along the length of the joint and it is not filled out. It is generally provided along the length. So as you can see that this is the length of the connection, and along this length we have provided the welded material. As you can see from this diagrammatic representation of the above picture, which is an actual image, because the welded connection in case of fillet weld has been provided along the length, that's why the critical stress for these type of welds is the shear stress. And the direct stress is also there, but that is not of much importance. So the criticality of the fillet weld, it lies in case of the shear stress, and that's why we will be designing these fillet weld for the shear stress. Now before coming on to the shear stress or the shear strength of the fillet weld, we need to understand certain terms regarding the fillet weld. So one by one we will study all of them. So this is a typical fillet weld which is shown to you, in which two plates of thickness, let's say this is T1 and this is of T2 thickness, they are connected together with the help of the fillet weld, which is shown with the orange color. Now it is showing us that this material is completely filled within the portion of the connection. Now the last point of this connection, that is known as the weld root, while the length which are provided along the two plates, that is known as the leg or the size of the weld. So the length of the welded material which is provided along the plate thicknesses, that is known as the leg of the weld, and the minimum leg length, that is known as the size of the weld. So the first term is regarding the size of the weld, and that is given by the minimum leg length. The other things that you can see from the image, that the end portion of the welded connection along the plate edges, that is known as the toe of the weld, and the top portion of the weld which will be visible to us, that is known as the face of the weld, and the thickness of the right angle triangle which is inscribed in this, the thickness from the 90 degree angle to the perpendicular bisector of the hypotenuse. If this is a right angle triangle which is inscribed in it, then this thickness is known as the throat thickness of the weld, which is very important in the calculation process. So this throat thickness is to be calculated. So this second one is the throat thickness. Now this throat thickness, if we want to calculate, so let's say this is a right angle triangle which is formed here. This is a right angle triangle, and if we drop a perpendicular bisector, this will also be a right angle triangle, and this is the effective throat thickness that is to be calculated. And let's say this is a triangle ABC and this is D. So from the triangle ABD, we can see that this angle D is 90 degree, that means the opposite side, that is a hypotenuse. So AB square can be written in the form of BD square plus AD square, because what we are dealing with, that is the calculation of the throat thickness, which is represented by TE. Now both the legs of the weld, that is known as the size of the weld, and that is represented by small s or the capital S. Now this AB square value is S square, that is equal to TE square plus AD value. This is to be calculated. Now this AC value from the bigger right angle triangle, it will be obtained as square root of 2 into S. That means this AD value, since it is a perpendicular bisector, it will be S by root 2 and its square. So from here, if we solve for this TE value, we obtain this value as S by root 2. or which may be represented as 0.707s. So this is the effective throat thickness of the fillet weld for the 90 degree angle, because that is dependent upon the angle between the fusion plates. So the caudal provision says regarding the different throat thicknesses depending upon the theta, that is the angle between the fusion plates. So if this is theta, then this PE, that is represented in terms of K into S, where K is a constant which is dependent upon the angle between the fusion plates. So for different values of theta, we are having the K value. So for theta having value between 60 to 90 degree, this K is given by 0.7. For 91 to 100 degrees, this value is given by 0.65. And if the value of theta is between 101 to 106 degrees, then it is given by 0.6. While if this value is 107 to 110 degrees, or that is increased up to 113, if this value is within this limit, then that is given by. So the effective throat thickness is given by the relation, that is K into S. K is a constant value which is dependent upon the theta, where theta is the angle between the fusion faces. So that we will see the code has provided for different values of K depending upon the different values of the theta. Now this size value, that is to be determined, because ultimately this S value is also to be calculated. So code has recommended certain minimum values and the maximum values, and if the designer has not mentioned about the size of the weld, then we will choose a suitable size of the weld from the minimum and maximum limits. So the minimum size of the single run fillet weld, that is given in table number 21 of the IS 800-2007 under clause 10.5.2.3, which says that it is dependent upon the thickness of the thicker part. So if you are having two plates, which the thicker one will decide the minimum size to be taken. If it is up to 10 millimeter, then the minimum size that is to be taken for the size of weld, that is 3 millimeter. Similarly, if it is between 10 to 20, then the minimum size of the weld that will be taken as 5 millimeter, which is usually the case. The second one is the most important case. Now, corresponding to it, the maximum size has also been limited. Other than that, certain note points has been given that when the minimum size of the fillet weld given in the table is greater than the thickness of the thinner part, the minimum size of the weld should be equal to the thickness of the thinner part. That means, let's say if you are connecting two plates that is having a thickness of 4 millimeter and other one is having a thickness of 16 millimeter. Now out of these two, we are having a thicker when we are 16. So that means we will be providing a minimum size of 5 millimeter. So in this case, we have ensured that the minimum size of the weld that is greater than the or equal to the thickness of the thinner member. So in this case, we will provide a size of weld as equal to 4 millimeter. Similarly, where the thicker part is more than 50 millimeter, because in this table, the values have been given up to 50 millimeters. So whenever the thicker part is having a thickness greater than 50 millimeter, special precautions like preheating, they should be taken. Now the IS code also recommends for the maximum size of the fillet weld, which is classified into two categories. So it is the thickness of the thinner member minus 1.5 millimeter. One value will be obtained from here and other value will be obtained from the thickness of the thinner member into 0.75, or it may be written as 3:4 ratio. Now this first will be used whenever we are designing for the plates. That means if we are providing the welded connection between the plates, then there the maximum size will be limited by this relation. While in the case of the angle sections, that means if this is the angle section, that is the there is certain edges which are rounded. So angle or rounded edges. In those cases, the second one will be used. That means the maximum size will depend upon the thickness of the thinner member. Or in this case, it will be the thickness of the angle section. So, it will be the thickness of the angle section. So the maximum size is limited for the two categories, that is for the plate or the flat ends. It is given by the thickness of the thinner member minus 1.5 millimeter, and for the angle section or the rounded edges, it is given by the 0.75 times of the thickness of the angle section, or it is given by the ratio as 3/4. So that limits the minimum size and the maximum size of the fillet weld and the throat thickness. Now throat thickness is dependent upon the different fusion angles. So these are the two plates which are connected together. Now the angle between them, that is known as the fusion angle. Now depending upon the value of this theta, this K value varies. So for a value between 60 degrees to 90 degrees, this is given by 0.7. If it is between 91 degrees to 100 degrees, then that is given by 0.65. If it is between 101 to 106 degrees, then that is given by 0.6. If it is between 107 to 113 degrees, then that is given by 0.55. And if it is in the last limit, that is 113 to 120 degrees, then that is given by 0.5. So that means the fillet weld, they are not recommended. They are not recommended for fusion angle less than 60 degrees or greater than 120 degrees. The angle between the plates should be lying between the 60 to 120 degrees. Then only we can provide the fillet weld, or it will be having the sufficient strength only in that case. Now when we want to calculate the length of the weld, so let's say this is the one plate which is connected to the another plate. Let's say I'm showing it in the plan section. So this is the plate. Along this length we have provided the welded connection. Now at the edges we do not terminate the connection as it is. We provide certain provision for the extended return. Now these values, these are known as the end returns. What is that? That we will see in a while. Now this length which we have provided, which is resisting the actual load, that is known as the length of the weld. Now this actual length, that will include these end returns also, because this is the actual length in which you have provided the welded material. Now if we subtract the end returns from the overall length, then the length remaining is known as the effective length of the weld, which will be actual length used for the transfer of the load and will be used in the calculation of the shear strength of the fillet weld. Now in any case, this effective length should be greater than the 4 times of the size of the weld. That means the minimum length that is to be provided for the effective length, that will be equal to 4 times the S value. Now these end returns, they are provided so as to avoid the abrupt ending of the welded connection at the edges, and because of the failure chances of the welded connection at the edges, we extend these values by S, that is the end returns, that is the size of the weld. So on both the sides we have provided S and S, that's why the effective length will be the overall length minus 2S. Or if there is any case, then in that case we may provide a 2S length. So this end return, it may be as equal to 2S also if the stress concentration is more. Now we will take a look at the design strength of the fillet weld. So the calculation for the strength for any parameter, I've told you that there will be the stress into area. Now the stress corresponding to the weld, the strength of the design strength of the welded connection, that is denoted by PDW. So the stress in the material, that will be given by Fu divided by a factor to reduce it down, that is given by root 3 into the area value is LW, that is the length of weld, into the effective throat thickness divided by the partial factor of safety for the welding, and that is given by gamma MW. So that is how we calculate the design strength of the fillet weld. Now here the Fu is the ultimate strength of the plate material that is to be connected. LW is the effective length of the weld, that is denoted by LE, or the length of the weld. Now this P TA is the effective throat thickness that is given by K into S, and this gamma MW is the partial factor of safety for the welding. Now that is taken as equal to 1.25 and 1.50. This 1.25 taken in the case of the shop welding. While if we are performing this welding at the site, or that is a field weld, then in that case we take the 1.5 values, and the difference between these two values, the reason behind that is in the shop weld we have more control over the quality which may be produced at the connection, while in the case of the field weld there are more chances of the nuisances, or the there may be more chances of the variation from the required quality. Therefore, we take a higher factor of safety in case of the fillet weld. Now, S is the size of the weld, which will be dependent upon the thickness of the thicker part. Now, the design procedure for any fillet weld, it includes the determination of the design capacity of the fillet weld. In the first step, we will calculate this. Now, either by providing this, if we want to calculate the design capacity, all the parameters will be known to us, and by that we will compare this PDW with respect to the P value, that is the applied force on the connection, and this P should be less than the capacity of the welded connection. In other type of problems, this PDW will be given to us, that means the load that is to be transferred, that will be given to us, and based upon that formula we will calculate the either the length of the weld, or the size of the weld, or the throat thickness. One of the parameters will be required to calculate. Now the two of the parameters that are remaining, that is end returns and the overlap. So whenever the fillet welds are provided, fillet welds are returned, that means they are extended at the ends so as to relieve the stress concentration, because at the edges there will be consistently load which will be applied, and in no case this end return shall be less than 2s. Now the last parameter which will be used in the case of fillet weld, that is the overlap. Now when we are providing the two plates with the help of the fillet weld, so the overlapping portion of the plate, that is known as the overlap, and the parameter which is used here, that will be important. So the overlap of any joint at the case of the fillet weld, it should never be less than. So the overlap which will be provided, that should never be less than, or it is limited by the two values. So it is either the 4 times the thickness of the thinner plate, or the 40 mm, whichever is maximum, that is decided as the limiting value for the overlap at the connection. So that completes the design procedure and the different terms related to the fillet weld. In the next video we will solve a numerical based upon the fillet welding. Thank you.